As a video says much more than words, here is a real example on Flight Simulator 2020.
Motion compensation off.
Without motion compensation, the headset thinks I'm moving and therefore takes me out of the simulator while in the cockpit reference frame I'm not moving. Of course, the greater the cockpit movements, the more motion compensation is required. On simulators with 100mm actuators, it is not at all essential. Here, the angles exceed 30 degrees and the stroke 620mm, so it is necessary to have motion compensation, as on the video currently. You see my view now stays perfectly in the middle of the cockpit. Here is today's summary, take a good coffee and let's go. This video is also available in French native language and German. Links in description. Now that we have seen the usefulness of motion compensation, I will try to explain to you, without going into details, the main principles. Of course, this only concerns people who play in virtual reality. When you play, the data is sent to software like FlyPT Mover via in-game telemetry. This software then transforms the game data into movement of the actuators according to the profiles you have configured. It then sends them via USB to the controller, here motion 4 SIM 32 bits, which in turn sends them to the actuator of the simulator, here the magnificent 6DOF Motion XP. In parallel, the game of course sends the data to the virtual reality headset, which displays it for the user. As you have surely seen in the previous video, the problem comes from the fact that the headset believes that the user is moving because of the movements of the simulator. This is where motion compensation software comes in. It will retrieve data from Mover via a virtual tracker and send the opposite to the headset environment. The sum of the two being zero, the user remains now fixed in his cockpit. Another possibility used by many users is to attach a controller to the platform, visible by the HMD or base stations. The movement compensation will thus be done with the controller, which does not move in relation to the headset, since it is also on the cockpit. This assembly seems much simpler, but unfortunately, the platform vibrates and the controller also vibrates. There is therefore a whole new adjustment to be made so that the view does not vibrate in the same way. There are other software options as FlyPT Mover, and there are also other ways, but we will talk in this video about the virtual tracker of FlyPT Mover and OpenXR motion compensation. I hope the explanations were clear enough. The subject is complex, don't hesitate to search on the internet if you want to go deeper. You probably know that there are at least two virtual reality environments today. OpenXR and OpenVR. In our case, we are going to deal with software that only works on OpenXR. There is another software called OpenVR Motion Compensation, which we won't discuss in this video. The first thing to do is to install the software. I invite you to go to the site linked in the description or search for OpenXR Motion Compensation on Google. You will find on the first page the link to the Discord or the email if you need to contact the developer, who is very friendly and available. A huge thanks for all the work he has done. I really invite you to donate whatever you can, because without this developer, we clearly could not use our big stroke simulators. I'll let you browse the main page if you want. We will look at how to install the software. We just need to download the latest version available on the site. When publishing video, it's 0.2.7. Nothing special for the installation, the software is very well made. In my case, there was just software that was launched that I have to close so as not to create a conflict. I'll talk about this software right after. Let's go back to the first page of the OpenXR Motion Compensation site. Another software is mentioned, which is called OpenXR Explorer and which will be very useful for you when in the OpenXR environment. I let you install it. Again, nothing special. Once launched, the software offers a lot of information. I admit to only using the part circled in red, which shows active OpenXR layers. In my case, you see there are three, OpenXR Motion Compensation and two other apps, NextSafer and Foveal Rendering for the Varjo. Even if it has no direct link with OpenXR Motion Compensation, I propose to show you how to activate or deactivate OpenXR layers. It is very useful, especially if you have problems. Type regedit into your Windows Start menu to bring up the registry editor. Then go to the address given at the top. In my case, there are four layers installed, including OpenXR Toolkit, which is a great application too and which I had disabled for tests. That's why it doesn't appear in OpenXR Explorer. To activate or deactivate them, nothing could be easier, just change the registry key. When it's 1, the layer is disabled, when it's 0, the layer is enabled. I'm going to disable everything and just leave Motion Compensation enabled. A second way is to launch Steam, then Steam VR, and go to the OpenXR settings. You can see that the current OpenXR environment is the Varjo. You can switch to Steam VR if needed, and finally this part displays the enabled or disabled OpenXR layers. You can now see that in OpenXR Explorer, there is now only the Motion Compensation application. After this little detour, let's get to the heart of the subject with the configuration of OpenXR Motion Compensation. I invite you to go to the folder highlighted in red. You will find there the config file, the .ini, the log file .log, and the user guide. In my case, there is a second .ini, since I saved my config before starting this tutorial. I strongly recommend that you make a backup of the initial file before modifying it. It will be important in case of further difficulty. Like the rest of the application, the .ini file is very well done and very detailed with all the information. I will not talk about the first lines that we are not going to change. The first option that interests us is this one, which allows us to activate Motion Compensation by default when launching a game. I invite you to do so, it's easier to use. You must then change the type of tracker. In our case, we are going to use FlyPT. Next, indicate the position between your headset and the center of rotation of the simulator in centimeters. In my case, and for my rig, it's 23 centimeters forward and 68 centimeters down. For those who have the awesome Motion XP6DOF rig, the value will change just a bit. It will need to be adjusted according to your height, but it's a good start. For those who have different rig, these dimensions will of course have to be adapted to yours. The COR will display as a multicolor cross as you can see. The following parameter enables the COR absolute position in your virtual environment. I really advise you not to use this function when you start using this software. In the same way, I suggest that you do not change the following parameters which have an impact on motion filtration. Finally, at the very bottom of the file are the keyboard shortcuts for using the software. You will find, for example, the activation, Ctrl plus insert, the centering, Ctrl plus del, the overlay activation, Ctrl plus D, and then several shortcuts that will allow you to refine the COR position. At first, this is not necessary. Finally, here are the shortcuts to save or reload the config, which can be very useful. Don't forget to save the file. Linked in the description, you will find a Stream Deck file with the main shortcuts. We now need to launch the virtual tracker in FlyPT Mover. In your profile, you must have motion compensation output for OpenVR-MC. It also works for OpenXR-MC. If you don't have it, right button, add, output, OpenVR-MC. For the tracker to be active, the small square at the top left must be red. If not, click on the output, open the window, and close it. It will activate it. Do not hesitate to like the video and subscribe if you are happy with the tutorial. In this window, you can see the filters for each degree of rotation. Personally, I put a low pass filter of 150, which works very well in my case. Finally, it is necessary to make sure that the simulator is correctly selected. If not, you just have to select it from the list. Everything is now set up. We will be able to test in game. I personally use DCS, but you can use any game you like, as long as it is under OpenXR.
10, 9,
by launching
8,
DCS,
7,
we hear the motion compensation
6,
countdown.
5,
it confirms that
4,
the layer is well activated.
3, 2,
remember to look
1,
straight ahead before the countdown end for
activated.
COR centering. By pressing Ctrl plus D, you can display or not the COR
overlay
cross.
Overlay activated.
We don't see it on screen because it's displayed at a higher layer than DCS, but I can see it between my legs in the VR headset. This cross, which represents the COR, is at this place because we put 23 cm front and 68 cm down in config file. We are now going to test motion compensation. To do this, I do not activate the rig, the platform does not move, and I make the sliders move in mover. If all goes well, the view should go in reverse of the motion of the simulator. For example, if I pitch forward, the view pitches backwards to compensate rig movement. You can test all degrees of freedom to check if everything works fine. For the heave, I cheated a little for movements to be amplified. It is important to remember not to save or restore the initial value. We can see that when the platform goes up, the view goes down, and vice versa. You can now give it a try with the platform activated and motion compensation.
Motion compensation activated.
It's much better that way. Now let's discuss about the main issues you may encounter. When you launch the game, the motion compensation software tells you error.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Error.
You just need to launch the virtual tracker in Mover. You just have to open the window, it turns red, and that's okay.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Motion compensation activated.
For those who have a Motion 4 SIM controller like me, the wheel of the remote display allows you to manage the movement scale. If the controller is not at 100%, then the rig moves will not be the same as the moves that Mover will send to motion compensation. Thus, there will be a gap between the two, and the motion compensation will be wrong. A common problem is also that you are not looking in front of you when centering the headset. When motion compensation activates at game launch, as the position of the COR is headset position related, it's very important to look straight ahead when centering the headset.
Tracker calibrated. Tracker calibrated.
When you center your COR, the rig must be in neutral position, waiting for his orders. as you can see on the left picture. You easily understand that if you press center when the rig is like center or right picture, COR won't be well positioned. The COR positioning is very important, as you have understood. For everything to work perfectly, the physical and virtual COR must be placed in exactly the same place. To fine-tune this point, I invite you to watch the video I have already made on this subject, the link is in the description. When you launch a game, if nothing happens, if you have no sound from OpenXR motion compensation, first check that the game you launch uses the OpenXR environment and not OpenVR 1. Thanks to OpenComposite, a lot of OpenVR games can be now switched to OpenXR. There are just a few manipulations to do, very well explained on OpenComposite website. If the game is in OpenXR, check OpenXR-explorer, as shown previously, to check if the OpenXR motion compensation layer is well enabled. If this is also the case, I invite you to return to the initial .ini file in the OpenXR directory. If it still doesn't work, you have to uninstall and reinstall the application. You can also check .log file in OpenXR-MC folder, searching for error string. Your last chance is to go OpenXR-MC Discord to ask help. Before I got a Varjo, I had a lot of headsets like the G2, Pico 4, Quest 2. All of these headsets use their own cameras for tracking, not external lighthouses. During fast movements, I often had positioning problem that I attributed to OpenXR motion compensation, but it was not the reason. Problems came from the headset tracking. The solution that worked well for me was to install QR codes on the walls so that the headset has high contrast references. You can see it on many of my videos. I also increased the room brightness. Hope this helped you. Don't hesitate to like, share and subscribe. If you have other requests or need more information, do not hesitate to contact me on Discord.